Welcome to Public House, intimate conversations with people making a difference in the Hudson Valley. And now, from Paula's Public House in Poughkeepsie, New York, here's Paula Young.
Hi, everybody. Welcome to Public House. I am sitting with County Executive Marcus Molinaro, and today we are going to continue our conversation of last week, and we're going to discuss the political climate, not just the environment. Hello, Marcus. Welcome.
Thank you.
So, we are in a country that is filled with change.
Yeah.
We are in a country that's filled with people with many polarized opinions. The county is starting to also become that way. I have a small, tiny run for public office myself, and I'm noticing that people that I like will start an email to me saying, I love you, but.
Yeah, with all due respect.
With all due respect.
If it starts with all due respect, they don't have it.
Yeah, everything before the but's a lie, everything after the but is true. So that said, you are going to be facing a challenge as county executive. You're being challenged by a Democrat with a Democratic governor in a county that is probably slightly more Republican than Democrat.
No,
the other way around?
Enrollment is actually significantly more Democrat than Republican.
Okay. Yeah. I believe that you are middle of the road enough that I don't think you alienate anyone from what I've read, what I've seen, what I hear. But what I notice is sniping, and I notice mistruths, and the political climate up there is affecting us.
Yeah, and it is. Listen, the antidote to anger is not more anger. The antidote to hate is not more hate. And the antidote to lies is not more lies. So where I will fail is that I will stay as steady keel for the residents of this county. I was once asked what worries me the most as county executive as to the national and state politics. I said it's lack of consistency. It's the lack of predictability. See, county government is a middle manager. I mean, our job is to manage things. We're not the town or village, so we don't have the direct impact that, local community elected officials have. We're certainly not state or federal, so we're not able to do sweeping policy change. Our goal is to make sure that as a region, a county region, we're growing in an effective and responsible way, that we're creating and supporting sustainable jobs, that we're protecting the quality and character of our community, and that we're ensuring for public safety. And by that standard, there is no county in the state of New York that does as well as we do. We have been able to expand services for mental health, for drug addiction. In fact, we're the model in the state of New York. What we do for those with intellectual and developmental disabilities is unparalleled in the country. And what I would offer to you is our investment in infrastructure makes our bridges, highways, and roads, county roads, among the best in the state. While at the same time we've driven down crime, we've effectively implemented criminal justice reforms that have protected both responded and protected victims and communities, but at the same time understands and supports the value and dignity of every life. We believe these things. And so what I'd offer to you is, yeah, the climate is as it is, and we know it. It is, there's a lot of anger, and I can understand why, I can. But my goal and my job, I think, for the last 8 years and certainly for 25 years has been to be as nonpartisan as possible and simply solve the problems, seek to solve the problems by building consensus facing the people I serve. And I just would say this, I actually believe in consensus. So what that means is not everybody has to give in a little bit. Everybody has to compromise.
But in any relationship, everybody has to give in a little
bit. Right, but we don't live in a political climate where that is all that acceptable or popular among some. And those that are running, they're going to lie. The goal
they
for me.
They have already.
Oh, my gosh.
About me. I mean, me, little insignificant me. I'm hearing things which are absurd.
Yeah.
And yet, what do you say?
I will say this to the camera and anyone else. My intention is not to diminish or demean my opponent. He should probably try to employ the same practice, which he said he would and isn't. I don't think that we benefit at all by tearing others down, but I do think that we ought to be held accountable. We ought to say what we believe and how we intend to achieve it, and we should be able to do that without dismissing or diminishing our opposition. And if you can't do that, then we see who you truly are.
I definitely agree that you have to put light where there is darkness, because then you can see what's there. And we would elect people based on the job that they have done. We don't necessarily want to bring somebody else who doesn't. I wouldn't hire a brain surgeon to cut my lawn necessarily, but maybe you could cut a lawn. Who knows? The questions are that people don't know what you do. They don't. People don't know what the county executive's role is. And because they view you as a high office, I think they expect you to be able to solve all the problems.
Yeah.
And then they blame you when you can't.
Yeah, but I'm comfortable.
Now, what's going on with crime right now? I think you've been able to do a lot because you've put good people in good places of authority. But the crime bills are changing now.
Yeah, I mean, it's just for public protection. I mean, keep in mind that much of that is the direct responsibility of the town or village that you live in. And I don't have, they don't report to me. There's a person in Fishkill who says, I should tell the town supervisor to do something. They don't work for me. They are your elected official. They work for you. My job is to try to manage regionally this community and how we respond to issues. But on the issue of crime, let me say, over the last 8 years, we've seen a significant reduction in criminal behavior. And it's mostly because we believe in two very important things. We believe in protecting the victims and preventing crime. And we believe in restorative justice, that there are those that, if given the tools, can find their way out of criminal behavior. We believe in those two things. But what Albany has done of late is changed the paradigm. Now, that is going to produce some immediate benefit to Dutchess County as a government. Smaller jail, less responsibility and cost for incarceration. But it's also putting people on the street that ordinarily wouldn't be there. And these are individuals who are making criminal decisions.
These are marginal people who are criminally marginal. Maybe they're not going to stab you, but doesn't mean they're not going to rob you.
Well, I will say this. You are correct. Although some of what the bail reform bill that Albany has now made into law does put people who do act in a violent way back out onto the street. But you're correct. These are individuals that, if given the right tools, can find their way back to living a crime-free life. And what happens in this county, we were the first to put public defenders at the time of arraignment. We were the first to put probation officers and our outreach officers at arraignment. Why? Because the very first interaction we have with somebody who commits a crime could define the rest of their experience. Right now, in Dutchess County, if you're brought into a courtroom, it is likely you're not going to jail. It is more likely you're going to go to drug rehab, you're going to go to workforce training, you're going to go to some alternative incarceration. Right. The problem with the new law is we'll never see those people. They'll never make the connection with the services until they're adjudicated, which is both good and bad, right? There's a constitutional right to be a presumption of innocence. You shouldn't be put in jail, but at the same time, these are individuals, many of whom are dealing with addiction and drug-related issues, and they're going to die. They're going to die because they don't have the support that they need to find their way out. And so we're going to miss those opportunities. The criminal justice reforms, the restorative justice, the human dignity reforms that we've implemented are not going to get to them until they finally find their way into a courtroom for adjudication. And those are weeks and months.
If they come back at all.
Now, most will. Most will. If anything, I'm at fault for believing in the capacity of people to do the right thing. But I will admit to you that some won't come back, and some will. But those that don't come back may very well leave the region, leave the community, or just avoid the judge. Some are going to die, because they're not getting the service and support that they need in order to find their way to a healthy life.
But for us, who are the people who live in homes, who have new televisions, that guy could come in and take my TV, my brand new TV that I worked really hard to save to buy. And that's the thing. And then they're going to turn around and blame you. But it's not a county issue.
No, it's a county issue in that we're stuck having to implement the law.
But the law is from Albany.
Albany, yes. We don't do penal code. We don't do criminal law at the county level. That's not our jurisdiction. The state of New York has occupied the field, is the term. That's their responsibility. I don't want people worried just yet. We've got a great law enforcement structure in Dutchess. One of the things we do, of course, is coordinate law enforcement, right?
Yes.
We have trained law enforcement in crisis intervention and mental health first aid. We're one of the few counties in America to be able to achieve nearly all of those on the street have that training. It's very important. That's what we do to ensure the community is safe. But the paradigm is changing. The dynamics will be different come January, and there will be people on the street who are likely to commit more crimes.
And you can say you don't want to alarm anybody. And when I read this and heard about it, it alarmed me.
Yeah.
And I'll tell you why. Because we have managed to, with consistency, get to a point where it's safe for the most part. Now, because we may want to please other concerns, we might make it less safe.
No, so what's happening in Albany has this, actually I will say, and Washington does this too. Listen, there are those in particular in New York City and other places that check the box when they legislate. They say, oh, fine, we've done this reform, but they don't implement it. They
exactly.
can't even run the trains.
Exactly.
So the failure to implement good ideas, or maybe even questionable ideas, but the failure to actually implement them in New York City and other major municipalities means that all municipalities are painted with the same brush. We had more people outside of the jail system than inside the jail system, because at the time of arraignment, at the time of connection with the individual, we immediately divert you. There are very few who are in our jail system that would ordinarily be in a jail system otherwise, but in New York City, because they have failed, they failed in implementing their policy, the rest of us are found guilty.
I don't want us to become New York City. Yeah. I don't want us to become Westchester County with taxes, with crime.
It's a short walk.
It's a very short walk.
When you're not allowed to speak up and stand up against the power brokers in Albany, when you're told that you should really kind of quiet it down, you end up looking like communities that are overpopulated. Suburbanization has overpopulated Westchester and Long Island, and they end up with massive taxes. Why? Because there is this desire among some to be all things to all people. Listen, county taxes are high enough.
Yes.
Dutchess County taxpayers pay enough property taxes. But we are relatively low as it relates to
in
the
comparison.
Rest. Of course, to Westchester.
And if we don't continue in the way we are going and manage it carefully, because it is a careful balancing act, I am afraid, having lived in the city, having lived in Westchester, that it's going to come here.
Yeah.
And then
you
where do we go?
Will you
we go to Alaska?
Be.
I mean, we just keep going north?
You should be, because it's the policies, those are the policies that continue to grow and cost and push people out of the state. And we're not saying that this is, I want a responsible community. I want us to spend your dollars well. And if I have to spend your dollar on something of value and importance, you're going to get me out in the community to explain it. But I'm not going to spend your dollar on something that isn't a county responsibility.
Exactly.
That isn't something we should be doing. Because ultimately, that begins to waste your resources and ultimately raise your taxes.
And I think the viewers and the voters need to be clear on exactly what everyone in office does, what the county executive or doesn't do, what the governor does or doesn't do, what your legislators do or do not do, and what they're responsible for. This is a conversation that will continue.
Let's.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Thank you for listening. I hope you found this as informative as I did. And we'll see you soon. Thank you. Thank you, Marcus.
You're welcome.
Hi, I'm Paula Young, and I'm the proprietor here of Paula's Public House. Do join me for good food, good cheer, and good fellowship. We are here, we have fun, and we'd love to have you be a part of it. Come on down.